The only sign you fought the glory of God was having your bills paid. You fought the glory of God was having a Mercedes or a Lexus or a Jaguar or having a mansion or having all the money that you need. Hey, listen to me. You could have all the money. You could have all the material things. You could have all the gratification of your flesh. And yet still, you could be in a dry place. You could be dead as a doorknob. Hey, listen to me. But the glory of God, Paul said, I'm crucified with Christ. He said, nevertheless, I live. It's not I, but Christ that's in me. Hey, listen to me. The glory of God, the glorious gospel, it's not about money. It's not about favor. It's not about power. It's not about position. It's about the word of God becoming flesh. It's about men and women denying themselves, taking up the cross, and following Jesus. I said the glorious gospel. If our churches were preaching the glorious gospel, hallelujah, we wouldn't be here tonight trying to travail, trying to pray, and trying to get revival to come forth. Hallelujah. Paul preached the glorious gospel, yet he was persecuted. He was hated. He was despised. He was rejected. He was imprisoned. Hey, listen to me. But out of all the persecutions and the afflictions, there came the revelation of God inside of Paul, saying, greater is he that is in me than he that's in the world. Saying, I'm more than a conqueror through Christ that's inside of me. Saying, I can do all things through Christ that strengthened me because of the glory of the gospel. He didn't just have a presence of the gospel. He had a glorious gospel. He had everything that God could have revealed in the gospel, which is Jesus Christ, the fullness of God. I say the fullness of God, the fullness of God himself. Teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lust, that we should live sober in this world, looking unto Jesus, who's the author and the finisher of our faith. Jesus was full of the glory of God, and there was no halo around him. He was not some kind of superstar. He was just like any other man. You don't have to be a superwoman with a cape. You don't have to be some superman. Hey, listen to me. To have the glory of God. Hey, listen to her. He said, the words that I speak, they are spirit and they are life. He said, if you don't believe what I say, believe me because of the works. He said, I don't do my own works, but I do the works of my Father. He said, I don't speak my own words, but I speak what the Father said. Are you listening to me? Glory to God. I'm tired of this program religion. I'm tired of this tradition religion. I'm tired, hallelujah, of man's doctrines and traditions and all the things that the elders and the bishops and the popes and all the doctors are handing down, all the psychology and the new Bibles. Everybody's got a Bible. Hallelujah. Everybody's got some kind of Bible. But I'm telling you, it's not going to take somebody's Bible. It's going to take the gospel. Hallelujah. The glory of God. The gospel of Jesus Christ crucified. The gospel of the one that died for you. Jesus. I said Jesus. Jesus of Nazareth. The glorious gospel. Let's go to St. John chapter 1. St. John chapter 11.
Hallelujah.
The glorious gospel.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
John chapter 11.
Glory to God.
Help them. Hallelujah. Touch them, God.
Thank you, Lord.
And from verse 1. It says, now a certain man was sick, named Lazarus of Bethany, the town of Mary and her sister Martha. It was that Mary which anointed the Lord with anointment and wiped his feet with her hair. whose brother Lazarus was sick. Therefore his sisters sent unto him, saying, Lord, behold, him whom thou lovest is sick. When Jesus heard that, he said, this sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, that the Son of God might be glorified thereby.
Yes.
Hallelujah. People get sick today. People get tired. People get weary. We put them in all kinds of places, all kinds of mental institutions, all kinds of places where they got to be cared for and nurtured for. But the gospel, the glorious gospel, the gospel that Jesus preached, the gospel that Jesus brought, hallelujah, when somebody died, Jesus said, this is not some sickness that is under death, but he said, this is something that has happened so that the Son of God might be glorified. Every time God healed the sick, it's the glory of God coming down. I don't care what the doctors say. I don't care what the doctors do. Every time God casts down a devil, it's the glory of God. In spite of your situation, in spite of your condition, you could have the glory of God. He said, for the glory of God to be manifested upon the sons of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Jesus said, as you go, preach the gospel. He said, heal the sick. He said, cleanse the leper. He said, raise the dead. He said, freely you have received it. He said, freely give it. He said, behold, I give you power over all the powers of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. I don't care the biggest witch in Jacksonville, the biggest wizard in Jacksonville, the biggest warlocks in Jacksonville, the biggest demons in Jacksonville. They got no more power than the power of the glorious gospel. They got no power than the power of the blood of Jesus. They got no power than the power of the anointing of the Holy Ghost. The glorious gospel.